Mataji, I guess you can leave it, Mataji. You send me the pics and everybody has a book in the call who joined. Only you and me only don't have, I think.
Actually, I don't have a book either, so.
Oh, you're not reading from book, Mataji?
I'm reading from what Supriya Mataji is posting on the group. Is that who's posting it?
Or who's posting it in the group? I did not check. I have to check. Okay.
Yeah, okay.
1 minute, Mataji, I'm sending.
Yeah, okay. You got
to
make it a little bigger. Actually, it's got to be a little bit bigger.
Yeah.
Okay. See if I can do this. So he was skeptical of lawyers who took money and did nothing. He chose instead to make a new application as religious minister for ISKCON. Although U.S. Immigration had denied his application, ostensibly on the grounds that he had been in the wrong immigration status, Srila Prabhupada suspected that the State Department was not overly fond of Indian swamis. I understand that the government of the USA is disgusted with so-called swamis because they have exploited the people in so many ways. That is a fact. And if I would have been in the government, I would have also considered like that. So they have not got a very good opinion about these swamis, about these rascal swamis. Under the circumstances, it will be difficult to get me admitted as a swami, although I am not a swami of the rascal group. We have to prove it by action that this swami is not like those swamis. This remark was made by Mr. Alan Burke of the television company. He introduced me to the public as, here is a real swami. And he showed me all respectful compliments. Anyway, I am not after respectful compliments by the public, but I am concerned about my disciples. I want to see them quite able to preach the sublime doctrine of Krishna consciousness, and therefore I wish to stay. Otherwise, I am not attracted for any place, either hell or heaven. Prabhupada accepted the denial of permanent residency in the United States as Krishna's desire and blessing. Now, instead of returning to the U.S., he would go to London and the European continent. Mukunda, Syama Sundara, and other disciples in San Francisco asked Prabhupada if they could open a center in London. And on June 7th, Prabhupada replied, as a sannyasi, I should not fix up at a certain place and take your service comfortably. It is not the desire of Krishna. He wants me traveling throughout the world. Wait, I haven't finished. Hold on a second, Mata. I didn't finish the last line. Okay. Well, Prabhupada never... No, next page.
Yeah, there is some more left, Mataji, in that paragraph.
Yeah, go back to 99. Or 98, was it 99? Yeah. Oh, no, wait, the page before that, actually. Yeah, okay, he wants me traveling throughout the whole western part of the world, and therefore I think it's Krishna's desire that, next page. Now I shall start my activities at least for some time in the European countries. So it is almost certain that I am going to London by the month of August. And if you all wish to come there, then you can prepare for the trip. Prabhupada, I'll stop there, Mataji. Somebody can continue.
Okay. Thank you so much, Raneshwari, Mataji. Mataji, if anybody would like to start from, Prabhupada's plan was to travel.
Hare Krishna. You want me to read, Mataji?
Hare Krishna. Yes, Mataji. Sundari Mataji. Please go ahead.
Okay. Hare Krishna. Prabhupada's plan was to travel and preach with a party of devotees who would support themselves by distributing Krishna conscious literature. But as Shyamchandra was already building a cart for the second annual Rath Yatra festival in San Francisco, and his wife was pregnant, Prabhupada advised him to wait. After Rath Yatra festival, and after his wife had delivered her baby and taken a month's rest, Shyamchandra and his family could go to England. Prabhupada asked that Mukunda also go. "I shall go to England for the time being," Prabhupada wrote Mukunda, "and start a center there which is long overdue. But more important than traveling or obtaining permanent residency in the US was the publication of Prabhupada's books. Prabhupada felt that writing and printing books was his best contribution in executing his spiritual master's order. So when Brahmananda came to Montreal from New York with the printers, galley proofs of Bhagavad Gita and teachings of Lord Chaitanya, Prabhupada was very pleased. Macmillan Company was publishing Bhagavad Gita and Prabhupada himself was publishing teachings of Lord Chaitanya through Brahmananda. Dai Nippon in Japan, because Brahmananda had contacted the editors at Macmillan Company, Prabhupada credited him with the success of the Gitas being published by such a famous company. Brahmananda was also Prabhupada's man for dealing with Dai Nippon. Both books were on tight printing schedules, and Brahmananda had to return quickly to New York with the corrected proofs. Brahmananda, "I came to show Prabhupada the galley proofs for both teachings of Lord Chaitanya and Bhagavad Gita. As it is, I just happened to have both galley proofs that had arrived." So it was a wonderful thing to bring these galley proofs to Prabhupada for checking. I was there only a few days, maybe a weekend or so. Prabhupada personally read through the entire galleys and made notations in his own hand. He did the proofreading of the galleys. Everything was done by Srila Prabhupada. It was very personal kind of thing. Of course, that gave Prabhupada great pleasure because he wanted his books published. And we had started to do it. So Prabhupada took great pleasure in proofreading those galleys. And he handed them to me. And it was very wonderful. Mataji, I want to stop here.
Thank you so much, Sundari Mataji.
No problem, Hare Krishna.
Hare Krishna. Hare Krishna Mataji, so would anybody like to start from next para when one of my books is published?
When one of my books is published, Prabhupada said, "I feel like I have conquered an empire. Having books in print gave meaning to Prabhupada's fight for the US residency. And only with these books published could he tour Europe." Krishna conscious literature was solid evidence that his movement was not a concocted fly-by-night yogi's dream. Let the government leaders and scholars read these books. Let the student community read them. Any intelligent man would be impressed. The books were the most enduring glorification of Krishna and the most powerful propaganda for spreading Krishna's teachings throughout the world. Far from being the speculations of any ordinary conditioned soul subject to mistake and cheating, these books contain the teachings and activities of Lord Sri Krishna, the science of Krishna consciousness, passed down by the great Acharya, giver the book of perfect knowledge. Before Brahmananda left to Montreal, Prabhupada asked him to send the Srimad Bhagavatam second and third canto manuscripts from the closet in his New York apartment. By October, as soon as the teachings of Lord Chaitanya was printed, he would have the manuscripts read for Dai Nippon. Speaking to Brahmananda and others in his room, Prabhupada charged them for the expectation of book sales. There would be no scarcity of books, but his disciples would have to sell them all. When Prabhupada had been alone in India, he had printed, gathered statements from scholars, advertised and distributed his books. But now he was depending on his disciples. They recognized the importance of books, but they had no ideas or means for distributing them. Prabhupada assured them, however, that by applying his instructions and trusting in Krishna for results, they would be successful. Prabhupada and Brahmananda discussed plans for starting their own printing press, perhaps in Montreal. With the cost of the printing so high, Prabhupada wanted some disciples to learn the techniques of book publication. He suggested that one of his disciples in New York learn to run a press and some of the girls learn to compose type. Thus, in the future, he might be able to start his own press in some convenient location. Hare Krishna.
Thank you so much, Preeti Mataji. Hare Krishna, Mataji, if anybody would like to start from next para, despite Prabhupada's plans.
Hare Krishna, Mataji, can I read?
Yes, Mataji, please.
Despite Prabhupada's plan of preaching in Europe, obtaining permanent residence in the United States and Canada, printing his books, and starting a press, his life remained regulated and simple. He would give Srimad Bhagavatam lectures in the temple and daily see the guests in his room. Constantly thinking, writing, chanting and speaking about Krishna and how to spread Krishna consciousness. Prabhupada was the driving force of revolutionizing this movement. He mostly stayed at home, spending much of his time alone or in a simple domestic dealings with his servants. One quiet afternoon in Prabhupada's sitting room, Govinda Dasi was bringing Prabhupada's his prasadam. When prasadam speak, a baby running across the floor. What is that?
When Prabhupada cried, Mataji.
Prabhupada cried.
Baby rat.
Okay. Prabhupada cried. Okay. That is here in the print, it shows different, okay. Prabhupada's side, a baby ran across the floor. Immediately, Govinda Dasi set the trays of prasadam down and tried to catch
the rat.
The rat, as it
darted
towards Prabhupada's desk. Getting up quickly from his seat, Prabhupada also joined excitedly in the chess. Then another rat appeared. When Harinama visiting from San Francisco heard the commotion, he came to the door and offered to help. Taking up a shoebox, he began to chasing the rats, finally catching them both and letting them loose. Loose outside. Later, Prabhupada walked into the room where Gaur Sundar and Govinda Dasi were working and told them, if you kept everything very clean, these rats wouldn't come. If someone is very much attached to have a dwelling, then he may take this mean birth in that dwelling as a cockroach or a rat. These are sinful living entities, and they are taking their birth because of their attachments. He then asked Shivananda to seal up the crackers in the floor. Sometimes when Prabhupada criticized Govinda Dasi for mistake, she would take it very emotionally and go into the bathroom and cry. One night while cooking, Prabhupada's puffed rice said, Govinda Dasi made the peanuts too dark. Why these peanuts black? Prabhupada asked. She served his prasadam. Why have you made them black? When Govinda Dasi began to cry, Prabhupada criticized her all the more. Why you are crying? Because you are angry. Why have you done this? This strange and anger look made
her tears come even harder.
Yeah, that's what I read. Tears come even harder. I am not angry. She sobered. I am very sorry. I made the peanuts too dark. I would like to stop here, Mataji. Thank you, Hare Krishna.
Thank you so much, Vinaya Mataji. Mataji, would anybody like
to go
from?
Thank you, Vinaya Mataji, and another Mataji name I don't know. Thank you for correcting me, Hare Krishna.
Not a problem, Mataji. Mataji, if anybody would like to go from next, once Govinda Dasi. Okay, Mataji, then I would like to read Mataji. Hare Krishna. Once Govinda Dasi lent the dictating machine to a god sister who broke it, and Prabhupada became disgusted. You American boys and girls, you are rich men's sons, so you simply think you can break something and then throw it in the street and buy a new one? You do not take care of such things. Only one person should use a machine. You should not have allowed her to use it. These words devastated Govinda Dasi, and she retired to cry for a while. But she soon recovered, and Prabhupada acted as if the scene had never taken place. Govinda Dasi took the chastisement as a test of her sincerity, and she had learned that Prabhupada's thunderbolts were generally followed by his usual kindness and gentleness. Prabhupada rarely went anywhere alone. For his disciples, it was unthinkable that he should go somewhere without one of them accompanying him to care for his needs or to confront
whatever difficulties.
One moment, Mataji. I'm projecting. Yeah. Whatever difficulties might arise. So when one afternoon Govinda Dasi looked in Prabhupada's room and found him gone, she became perplexed. Seeing that his shoes were gone, she ran out to the street. Unable to see him in there, in the direction, she ran down to the corner where she saw him in the distance walking away. She finally caught up to him. She asked in a voice distraught and breathless, "Where are you going? Why have you left?" Prabhupada laughed quietly as he walked erect with his cane, his movements flowing. "Oh," he said, "I am just going to the bank. It's all right. I will be back." Govinda Dasi apologized for being so demanding. "I just thought you shouldn't go alone because you have been ill." Prabhupada snapped back, "What do you know? Physician heal thistles?" And he walked on, leaving Govinda Dasi behind. As far as Prabhupada was concerned, it was Govinda Dasi who was sickly, not he. She was always bundled in sweaters and coats or blowing her nose. Once he had gone into the room where she and Gaurasundara worked, and it had been seen messy with tissues thrown here and there. "This is why you are always getting sick," he had said, "because of uncleanliness." Another day, Prabhupada, accompanied by Gaurasundara and Govinda Dasi, was walking out of the house on his way to the temple when he began laughing, saying, "Yes, Govinda Dasi, everything is nice. You are an excellent secretary, an excellent cook, and you are good at everything. Your only disqualification is that you are a woman. But don't worry, next life you shall be a brahmachari." "Thank you, Srila Prabhupada," Govinda Dasi replied, enjoying Prabhupada's joking mood. Gaurasundara was a quiet young man, steady in his duties. He liked to study Prabhupada's books and could understand the philosophy, although negligent about studying Bengali and therefore sometimes unable to translate the verses Prabhupada had assigned. He was a careful servant, and Prabhupada was... Prabhupada was pleased with his work. So, Mataji, I would like to stop here, and can anybody can continue from next? Off and Prabhupada.
Okay. Mataji, you want me to continue?
Mataji, we will see other Matajis who did not get a chance. Then
sure.
We can continue, Mataji. Mataji, Mataji, who did not get a chance, would you like to continue, Mataji? Okay, Sundari Mataji, please go ahead.
Okay, Hare Krishna. Often, Prabhupada, taking the shelter of Mayavadi, would debate with Gaurasundar. Early one morning, Srila Prabhupada walked into the room where Gaurasundar was sleeping and woke him with an argument of Mayavadi philosophy. Krishna's personality must be a product of illusion because the absolute is defined as beyond personality. And Gaurasundar had to immediately refute the argument. Prabhupada would sometimes remark that eventually Gaurasundar and Govindasi should travel together to some part of the world and preach. Krishna consciousness had to be introduced in so many places, and Prabhupada envisioned that one day his servant and secretary would go off to open a new center. Taking care of my body, he said, is not such an important thing. One day, Prabhupada and Gaurasundar were discussing philosophy while Govindasi spent a long time in the kitchen washing pots and dishes. The noise of her cleaning carried into Prabhupada's room. She has this cleanliness disease. Prabhupada warned, my wife and daughter also had it. You should catch it while it is not developed. Otherwise, it will get worse. I caught my daughter once. She was washing the electric socks pockets by splashing water onto them. And I told her, do not ever do this. If you do this, I will kill you. So she promised she would never do it again. While Prabhupada was in Montreal, many of his disciples from the United States came to visit him. They were serving on his behalf, some of them 1,000 miles away. And the urge to see him would grow until it impelled them to travel to Montreal. Sometimes these visitors would be newcomers who had joined one of Prabhupada's temples and had heard about him from his disciples, but had never seen him. Prabhupada was always happy, of course, when his disciples remained in their posts, executing their respective duties. But he was also glad when they came to visit him. Nandakishwara, I walked into the room and Srila Prabhupada greeted me very enthusiastically with a smile and said, American Vaishnava, I paid obeisances, sat down, and we began to talk. I heard that Krishna could be in the heart of every living entity at the same time. So I asked Prabhupada, how was it possible? He began by saying, just try to understand. So I tried. I strained and squinted to show that I was really trying to understand. And Prabhupada continued, just like the sun is over your head and mind, and is over the head of someone who may be 1,000 miles away, that is because the sun is great. Similarly, Krishna is so great that he simultaneously is in the hearts of all living entities. And I understood. He had said, try to understand. And because I was hearing, I did understand. I was trying to understand and I was hearing from the pure devotee. As I was leaving his room, he waved his right hand in the air, sitting back in a very relaxed way, smiling. He said, chant Hare Krishna, chant Hare Krishna. Okay, Madhuri, I want to stop here.
Okay, thank you so much, Sundari Mataji.
Thank you so much.
Mataji, then anybody would like to continue from Krishna Dasa? Okay, then I will read Mataji's. Krishna Dasa. I had heard that Prabhupada was planning to travel abroad and that he wanted to take several devotees with him and that whoever wanted to go should save his money. So I got a job with a jewelry firm. Then I had a vacation while Prabhupada was in Montreal, Uttava, and I were having our vacation at the same time. And we decided over breakfast one morning to go to see Prabhupada in Montreal. In our hour, we were packed. In 1 hour, we were packed. Wearing suits, we hitchhiked from San Francisco to New York in 3 days. When we got to Montreal, Gaurasundara said, well, Prabhupada is about to have lunch. Would you care to join him? We said, yes. Uddhava and I went in. And Prabhupada was immediately very thankful that we had come so far to visit him. But as we had come to lunch so late, there wasn't really enough prasadam for two guests. So Gaurasundara first served
Prabhupada.
Served Prabhupada, and we sat there with our empty plates. There Prabhupada asked, what about their food? Govinda Dasi went to get something for us, and Prabhupada said to me, you are very thin, you look sickly, you should eat more. So he proceeded to take food off his plate and put in on my empty plate, and he told me to eat. He said I should eat 6 chapatis a day. He gave me a whole diet to follow so I could gain weight. During lunch, a moose came into the room. A mouse came into the room, and Gaurasundara captured it. Prabhupada joked about how the mouse had been a devotee in his past life, and he had come back in this life to eat prasadam off the floor. Afterwards, we paid our obeisances. I touched my head to Prabhupada's foot, and he got up and walked over and rubbed our heads. Jagadisha Dasa. When I entered Prabhupada's apartment, I got the most amazing feeling. Kirtanananda Maharaj and Hayagriva were there talking to Prabhupada about New Vrindavan. They were saying that they had brought some land and Prabhupada was encouraging them. I just sat in the back and listened to what was going on. Prabhupada's presence was very strong. I felt small and I had the feeling that he knew everything about me and that I couldn't pretend to be someone big. All the previously I had always thought of myself as being a little advanced, but in Prabhupada's presence I couldn't pose as anything because I understood that he knew everything about me and could understand my mentality. So I just sat with my face turned downwards. Once in a while, I would look up at him. I was in Prabhupada's room for about half an hour. I wanted to say something, but I didn't know what to say. So at the end, while everyone was leaving, I bowed down and let the others leave first. Then as I was about to leave, I told Prabhupada that I was chanting 16 rounds daily and that I expected to get initiated later. He welcomed me to stay in the Montreal temple and I fumbled some reply. Vaikuntha Natha. I was in great anxiety because I had just... Yeah, that's it, Mataji. Thank you so much, Mataji, for joining this reading and reading it wonderfully in spite of our small difficulties. Thank you so much to all the Matajis who joined this reading. So I would like to request Matajis, can we please share our realizations? Preeti Mataji, Sundari Mataji, Shamakori Mataji, Kamodaki Mataji, Vinaya Mataji, Vrindagopika Mataji. And I see another member, Mataji. Can we all start sharing our realizations, Matajis?
Hare Krishna, Mataji. Before sharing the realization, I want to ask a question. Like, I did not understand the first time, like, Govinda Dashi burned the peanuts and Prabhupada was saying why these peanuts are black and like, you know, I did not understand the essence of this.
Yeah, there Govinda Dasi is cooking Mataji and the foodstuff, whatever she cooked like peanuts, it became black. So Prabhupada was a little bit angry about why the foodstuff is becoming black. It was like burnt.
Over roasted, Mataji.
Is that the thing, Mataji, Shamagauri Mataji, you are asking?
Yeah, that's the thing. So what Prabhupada was saying?
He was angry. Why Govinda Dasi is not careful while cooking?
Yeah.
So he was chastising Govindadasi, you should be careful not to burn or not to overcook, or you should be careful while cooking. And the main point Prabhupada is telling Govindadasi.
Yeah, yeah, yeah. Got it, Mataji. Thank you.
Yeah, thank you, Mataji.
Hare Krishna, Mataji.
Hare Krishna, Praneshwari, Mataji.
Yeah, I'll share. I was just thinking, the first when I was speaking about Govindadasi, when Srila Prabhupada said, you're crying because you're angry, I thought that was very interesting, because I think, as I think back, a lot of times, even children, when they get chastised, they're not chastised because they're not feeling bad because their feelings are hurt. It's because, and I think I recognize this in myself also, it's because we're angry that our ego has been hurt. So we're angry, and that's what. So I just thought that was very, very intuitive of Srila Prabhupada. Also, I think that whole mood of, you know, you've got to be clean. You know, it's because of you're not clean, it's because of your uncleanliness that's why there's so much. Now, Prabhupada had to teach them so many things. I mean, from the basics. You know, we can see how much from how much he had to teach them. But at the same time, we can also see how willing they were to learn, how willing that all the devotees were to listen. And also in the beginning part, when Srila Prabhupada was explaining to the immigration department that, you know, I did things according to what you said, and, you know, I followed your instructions, and that's why I applied the way I did. He wasn't being apologetic. He wasn't being begging them for anything. He was just stating the facts, you know, and it shows how he was just willing to go with whatever Krishna delivered, whatever Krishna put him in. He was just going to, you know, his old focus was just preaching and making sure that this message continues, whether he's there or not. So, you know, I thought that was wonderful, and it was hilarious. And it was hilarious when, you know, they were chasing the mouse around, and
Srila
Prabhupada saying, Govinda, you're very good at this, you're very good at this, but it's just uncleanliness, it's uncleanliness, it's got to go. So those are three things that stuck in my mind. I just thought he was just very, very sweet. And also when he saw the two devotees, the Jagadish, I think it wasn't somebody else that come, was it Brahmananda or Goat? I don't remember who it was that had come, and they didn't have any prasadam. And he told them, you have to eat six chapatis, and he gave them prasadam from his plate. I mean, that's what a father does. That's what a really loving father does. And he just epitomized that, you know, of his, you know, his loving nature and his how he dealt with his disciples as his children, you know, as a loving father. So it just touched my heart. Thank you, Mataji.
Yes, Mataji, yes. And at the same time, he was chastising, and at the same time, he was showing his kind of affection, both the qualities. Yeah, thank you so much, Praneshwari Mataji. Mataji, I could not see your name in the on the phone, a number. Is your number is changed, Mataji, or the same one?
It's the same one, but for some reason, it's coming up as an anonymous. I don't know why it comes up as an anonymous.
Oh, okay, your number, Mataji, okay. Yeah, anonymous, okay, okay. Got you, Mataji. Yeah, thank you, Mataji. Thank you so much.
Hare Krishna.
Hare Krishna. Preeti Mataji, Vinaya Mataji, Sundari Mataji, Vrinda Gopika Mataji, Kamodiki Mataji.
Hare Krishna, Mataji. Very nice reading. I really like the reading today, and the discussion of Govindadasi getting chastised and got upset. That was really very nice. Usually, I generally get upset very fast. Somebody tell me something, immediately tears fall from my eyes. So I could see that that's not good for us. Even Prabhupada is chastising. That's not like I feel that I'm sensitive. I'm not sensitive. I'm egoistic. If somebody says something, I'm getting angry over there. That's why I'm crying. I could realize that. It was so nice. And also, Prabhupada was telling for one reason why she was feeling sad for, she is a woman,
that she could not do something, and Prabhupada said that you're going to come in the next life as a brahmachari. That really struck me. Usually, you know, Prabhupada would have blessed her like them, you will go back to Godhead. But here you blessed like you'll come back as a brahmachari. It was really striking for me. Yeah, those 2 points I really like, Mataji. It was very nice reading. And cleaning, about the cleaning, keep the house neat and keep the things neat. Prabhupada was very strict at clean, and anything he wants to be correct. If he sees something like that, we see so many times Prabhupada has keep on telling that for us to keep clean, it is very good for us. Yeah, Mataji, that also I really like. Hare Krishna.
Yes, Mataji, yes. Nice, Mataji, nice point. I like the point where you are highlighting that Govinda Dasi should come back as Brahmachari. Yeah, that is a really striking, Mataji. Thank you, Vinaya Mataji. Thank you so much. Mataji, can anybody share their realizations? Sundari Mataji, Preeti Mataji, Kamodiki Mataji.
Mataji, Sundari Mataji and Preeti Mataji is not on the call, Mataji.
Okay. I think, everybody left. I think Preeti Mataji is there, I think so.
It is Shyamagauri Mataji.
Shyamagauri Mataji, okay. Okay, then I will share my realizations, Mataji. Yeah, that's just most. Praneshwari Mataji and yourself covered everything, Mataji. And I liked where the Govinda Dasi is telling to Prabhupada that you are sick, you cannot go alone. And Prabhupada very laughingly told that I am not sick, you are sick. You are always covering yourself with rugs and sweaters, and you are sneezing, coughing. And when I enter your room, you have so much of tissues spread throughout the room. And because of this, you are so much sick. So he is telling that it was like very hilarious how Govinda Dasi is taking care, but instead she has to take care of herself. She has to be first in very good healthy condition. And again, about prasadam sharing and cleanliness also. And Prabhupada is telling not to be more into cleanliness. He is telling whenever this disease of cleanliness comes in the early stages, we have to pick it up and we have to work on it. We have to be not that much cleanly. One incident Prabhupada is citing that his wife and daughter is also into this habit of being very cleanly. And once her daughter is cleaning the electrical switchboard with water. So we can understand how much they are into cleaning. And Prabhupada warned her, if I see again cleaning this with water, I will kill you. So Prabhupada is telling that not to waste our time in much of cleanliness. In another lecture also, from another speaker, I heard that most of the Matajis are wasting their time and cleaning all the things, whatever they get in touch with. So that is also too much, not recommended, that much cleaning. I have heard in other class also. Yeah, and reminding things, yeah, very much interesting, Mataji. Yeah, that's all, Matajis. So I think we can end the call, Mataji. If there are
no more, Mataji, with we are very bad luck. I don't know why they are not uploading it. It's missing a lot.
Yes, Mataji. And we have to be very thankful to Yaltangi Mataji. She sent the photos of the pages, and we are able to continue our reading without uninterruptedly.
Yes, Mataji. At least we got this. Thank you to Lalitangi Mataji.
Lalitangi Mataji. Yes, Mataji. Yeah. Okay, Matajis. So once again, I am thankful to all the Matajis who joined this session. So I would like to pay my obeisances to all the Matajis. Vancha kalpa tarubhyasya krupa sindho vyaye vacha patitanam pavanebhyo vaishnavebhyo namo namaha. Anantakoti vaishnavrindu ki jai. Namachara Srila Haridas Thakur ki jai. Srila Prabhupada ki jai. Leelamrita ki jai. assembled devotees ki jai. All glory to Srila Prabhupada Guru Maharaj.
Hare Krishna. Mataji ki jai.
Ameliya Mataji ki jai. All glory to Srila Prabhupada. Hare Krishna Mataji. Hare Krishna. Thank you so much.
Thank you, Mataji. Happy Ekadasi to everyone. Thank you so much.
Happy Ekadasi, Mataji. I would like to. Mataji, can anybody stop recording, Mataji?
Sure, Mataji. I'll stop it.
Oh, okay.